Like this video the next 5 seconds or you guys will never get an ankle breaker again in NBA 2K21 next gen. I would not risk it. In this video today, guys, I'm going to show you guys the most glitchy dribble moves in this game, hands down. These are hands down the best dribble moves to watch. I just double dribbled first off, and now watch this. I'm going to teach you guys how to do that. Do you guys see this move? That is insane. These dribble moves are hands down the best in NBA 2K21. And not only is dribble moves the best to get open every single play, but you can also break anyone's ankles anytime you want. As you guys see, I broke them there. And both times he's falling, and you think I'm done. That's why it's funny. Let's hit him one more time. And as you can see, I make a fall for the third time. These dribble moves are insane. Watch the whole video through, and you guys will do this too.
I was just trapping. I cannot tell you what the fuck just happened. Used to have all the static, now I don't really care about nothing, just want the cabbage. And I just want a bad bitch. She set me up and she leaving the back end. And she leaving on weekend. These bitches be bugging, these bitches be. I gotta get to these pesos. Now I smoke on my dope, I don't chase hoes.
YouTube, what is good with y'all boys? It's your boy Chad here, back with another banger, man. In today's video, I'm probably dropping one of the more helpful videos on my channel. Today, it is the best dribble moves NBA 2K21. Now, I know I've dropped this before. I think it's the third time dropping this year, but it's my new updated moves. And I had to make this video because, honestly, I updated so much dribble moves, it's going to be hard to explain. Now, as you guys saw in the clips, these dribble moves are insane. They're really, really good. They're fast. They get open and they break a shit ton of ankles. So before we end this video, before I show you guys dribble moves, I need everyone to drop a like, hit the sub button right now, and hit the bell, turn on the post notifications to all before we get into this. I'm going to show you guys in this video the best badges, the best controller settings, and I'm also going to even tell you each dribble move. I'm going to break down and tell you guys what's so good about the move and why I chose it. And I'm going to show you guys in the MyCourt and the Gatorade facility how to, I'm not going to tell you how to do these animations because I may drop a dribble tutorial later. And if you guys want a dribble tutorial, get to 500 likes on this video and drop a dribble tutorial in the next video. So like I said, man, I'm gonna get into the badge and the control settings first, but yeah, without further ado, let's get into it. Make sure you guys hit the like and sub button. Alright guys, I'm gonna talk about obviously the badges. I'm not gonna waste too much time because it's just stupid, okay? I mentioned this in my video last video. Tight handles is pretty good. It's not necessary, but it's pretty good. Ankle breaker, if you want to break ankles, this is a must. Obviously, I can only get on gold. You can get a Hall of Fame, do it. This badge is actually really, really good. That's why I break all these ankles. It's actually good this year. It's definitely worth it. I 100% will put on ankle breaker if you have enough playmaking badges. And obviously, handles for days is a must. Your player doesn't get tired while just dribbling without like gasping for air. And a quick first step, it's self-explanatory. You don't want to move like a snail. Next thing I'm going to is takeover. Obviously, in this player, I was playing mobile, that's why I had this. But if I was fucking around and just want to do some crazy shit on the ones court, 100% put on anger breaking shots, takeover. As you guys see, increase the likelihood of dropping defenders. That's all you need to hear. That shit is insane. You do one little spin move and they go flying. You guys have seen clips of me doing it. Anger breaking shots is a really good way to become better at dribbling and breaking ankles. And so obviously I'm going to control settings now, and there's only two that I really want to talk about. I've talked about this almost every single video. And it's pro stick function and pro stick orientation. The pro stick function is on default, and the pro stick orientation is on absolute. For pro stick function, you don't want default because you don't want it on just shots, because then you can't dribble with it. And you don't want it on just dribble moves, because then you can't dunk with it, which I do a lot of. As you guys know, I'm running towards the hoop, hold down the right stick. You don't want it on default. And then for the pro stick orientation, if you have a camera relative, wherever you are on the court, let's say on the top of the key or in the corner, the controls are going to be different. So you want to have on absolute, so no matter where you are on the court, the controls are exactly the same as if you were on the top of the key or in the corner. So have these two on 100%. Alright guys, now I'm going to go to the Gatorade facility and I'm going to go show you guys all the moves that I have on my player, and I'm going to show you guys in the court, like on the court dribbling, and showing you guys how, like which move corresponds with each. And just a quick like, you know, little reminder, you guys have to have at least an 80 ball control, to get these pro dribble moves. All these dribbles I'm going to show you guys in this video today is you have to have a minimum of 80 ball control. If you have anything less, you're not going to be able to get it. So that being said, if you have a 76 ball control at 99, you're going to have an 80 ball control, which means you could get these dribble moves, but whatever you do, at some point, you're going to have an 80 ball control. And if you don't have that, you can't do these dribble moves. All right, y'all. So here we are in the Gatorade rental course. And obviously, I'm going to show you guys my dribble moves before we get onto the court. Dribble style, quick. That's what I like. You can do whatever you want. It's that or LeBron James. Top two, right? Hands down. I like quick. LeBron James gives me a weird animation every time I do my John Wall signature size up. So I do quick. Signature size up. I just said it. John Wall. John Wall is very important. It's where you do like the little, you know, hesitation move I always do. If you want to dribble like me, you 100% have to have John Wall on. Park size of 14. If you guys don't know how I use park size ups, it's actually my most recent video. I just explained my most recent video. It's a really big help in doing a speed glitch that I honestly use a decent amount. So I would put on park size of 14 if you guys want to. Obviously, you have to have tight handles Hall of Fame to do this, but it's not necessary, but I use it a lot. Basic size up packages, pro one, you need to have on. That's how I do my little spam through the legs shit I do. You guys probably see me in my streams a lot. I spam all the time. And it's also how I do my little step back as well. Pro basic size up package one. is the best. Set up skate package. You want Pro 2. This is how you do Steph Curry. It's how you do the Steph Curry, you know, escape. What is it? Curry size. That's what it's called. Curry size. I see the Curry size. So you want Pro 2 escape packages, hands down. Let me cross over. You do Pro 2 or Pro 8. They're both good. I like Pro 2 because I've been using Pro 2 for like years now, for a long time. So I would do Pro 2. Pro 3 behind the back is a must. Look at the animation. This one right here. That's the one I do all the time. You guys see me do that all the time. Pro 3 moving behind the back. You need this fucking move to cook in the park. Like, I do this all the time. You probably see it. It's a really good move. Basic spin. Basic spin one is also a spin you have to have. This is how you do the spin back. This is how you do the glitchy spin move. How I break everybody. If you guys want to do that move, I have a video a while back called Spin Glitch. It breaks ankles all the time. Basic one spin is the way to go. Hesitation, I don't think it matters that much. I'm going to be honest with you. I never really thought hesitation this year was good at all. Pro 5 is, you know, is what I have on. If you want to put on my move, you can. I don't think it does that much, honestly. And the last one that matters is Pro Step Back, or Moving Step Back Pro 3. This one helps a lot, more than you think. I do this a lot, but you probably wouldn't realize it. I'll show you guys when I get on the court, but this move helps a lot. If you guys want the best moving step back, put on Pro 3. Alright, bro, so I'm gonna go over the most important moves that obviously I went through all the gym moves. I'm not gonna go through all of them. I'm gonna go through the ones that you need. I'm gonna show you guys why it is so effective. So the first one I'm gonna go over, I've told you guys many times before how to do this. I've had a bunch of speed boost dribble glitch videos on it, and it's insane. The John Wall has a package right there. That's honestly a huge speed boost. It gets me open 90. I'm not even kidding. If I played a park game, I would probably do this move at least 10 times, minimum, in this game. That move is insane, the John Wall speed glitch. If you guys want to know how to do that, 500 likes for a dribble tutorial. Next one, park size up, is how you do this, how you do that animation right there. And it's pretty OP when you do the speed boost out of it. As you guys see, that speed boost is kind of weird as fuck, but it's a little effective because no one's expecting that shit. So park size of 14 is how you do that. There's one more time, easy dunks every single time. It's a pretty good move. Basic size up package is probably one you need if you want to be able to do this. I do this all the time. I just spam this shit and I freeze people and I rerun every time right by them. It's a pretty good spam move. Basics has a package Pro 1. And you also, this is the move that you guys need to do that. Everyone was asking me how I do that. It just literally flick the right stick back. But you keep going, stop and dime and flick back. That move works a lot and it's all from Basics has a package Pro 1. Escape package is Pro 2. I'm not going to go too much into it. Curry slide. That's all it is. Curry slide. When crossover doesn't matter. The behind the back I wanted to show you guys. Obviously, you guys probably have seen me do this many, many times in my gameplay before. But it is just this. That move is insane. It breaks ankles and it creates insane separation. If you guys know when to do that, that move gets almost everybody and I get a dunk almost every single time. It's a pretty easy move to do. I'll be my dribble toy as well, but this shit is insane. Put on behind the back Pro 3. And there's two more moves I want to talk about in this video and show you guys what it can do. One is obviously the spin, which is obviously basic one. Spin back, you can do whatever you want. You can just spin back, or you can do this glitchy spin move that I've been doing for the longest time, breaking ankles every single play. All stems from basic one spin. It's a really good spin. I don't know why basic one is so good, but it is. Like, it's basic one, so you wouldn't think it's good, but it's the best spin in the game, hands down. You definitely should put on basic one spin if you guys don't have it on already. And the last one I'll talk about is the one that I said you probably don't notice it, but it does have a big impact on my game, which is a step back three, Pro 3. And that's the move it does right there, and it's pretty glitchy if you get it down pat. Like, no one expects you to run off that really fast. Obviously, it doesn't look like too much, but once you do this, rim running, it's almost impossible to guard. I have Pro 3. All these rim moves are going to help you out, so obviously I showed you all of them. These are what you guys can do with the dribble moves. It's insane. Put these on. Trust me, and you become a better dribbler. As long as you practice every game, you'll be cooking people in the park 100%. But like I did say, you guys do have to practice these moves, and I'll give you guys a dribble tutorial with these moves. Like I said, if you guys drop 500 likes on the video. And honestly, if you guys made it this far in the video, make sure you guys, I want you guys to comment GOAT in the comment section, alright? If you guys don't comment GOAT in the comment section, you're fake. I don't know who's real, but who commented GOAT. If you guys made it this far, comment GOAT. I would appreciate it. Alright, man, yeah, that's really it for the video. Hopefully this video helped. Like I said, practice. If you guys want a dribble tutorial, I got y'all. And honestly, these moves are the best. It's not even close. The better you get at them, the better you're gonna get at the game. And I can promise you that with 100% certainty. Alright, guys, and that's it for the video. Everyone have a great day. I'm out. Make sure I hit the like and sub button before you guys leave. And peace.